Well done. Done, you made it.
Thank you very much.
All that way.
All that way.
Okay, so you had to drop out. Where was it?
Eastmere. It's about 72 miles.
And what was the problem?
My feet and the terrain didn't agree with each other. So the terrain won.
How do you feel? Disappointed, obviously.
Slightly disappointed, but all ready for next year, so get ready for that.
Did well, though.
Yeah.
To get down that far.
It raised about £500, so it's worth it.
So you were being sponsored, were you?
Yeah.
So was it based on how far you got, how much you raised?
No, it's for doing it.
Just doing it, taking part.
Yeah.
Well, it was a long, hard slog, but we saw you a few times around the room and you did well, so congratulations.
Cheers, thanks.
Cheers.
Yeah. I couldn't have done it without my partner here. Right?
Yes.
Partner, come on.
You both look quite fresh, actually.
Well, you know, people keep... Yes. People have been saying that to me. They keep saying, are you sure you are?
If you saw some of the people that came in yesterday, you
know,
you really look fresh.
Yes. Yeah. We're all right, actually.
We're not bad. Feet are all right. We're just slow. We get around in our own time.
Well, we've done it before the deadline.
Yes.
We have, yeah.
And it's a long, long way. So you went for a second ride, obviously.
Yeah.
Yes.
How did you find it? It must have been a bit cooler last night.
No, actually, it wasn't.
No, it wasn't.
No. No, there was a bit of a breeze the first night. And the temperature dropped more than it did last night, didn't it? Actually, it might have been because we were a bit lower down last night rather than. On the first day.
We tried to get to Beacon Hill before dark fell, because that was a long leg and we knew that it wouldn't be much fun trying to get to Beacon Hill in the dark. I know some people would, but we did that, and then after that it's another night out.
Congratulations, anyway.
Thank you very much.
Well, you set a shining example of looking fresh when you're walking for 48 hours.
It's all an illusion.
Well done. Thank you. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
Are you talking to my brain or my feet?
How are they?
Sore.
Yeah,
sore. Can imagine. But the brain is fine.
Overall, good.
A wonderful experience. Really enjoyable. Thank you.
How did you do it? Just kind of pace yourself.
Take our time. Knew we were going through two nights. Yeah. Plenty of rest and plenty of food and drink. And enjoyed.
Have you
enjoyed.
Done 100 before?
I have. This is number 19.
Number 19.
Yes.
Okay. So you're experienced.
Oh, I don't know about that.
What's your name?
Keith Warman.
Now this is where all the action is, where all the hard work's going on.
Yeah.
There's the Gordon Ramsay and Bolton here. Preparing breakfasts.
Hello.
My gloves.
Yes.
Look, holes in them.
You've got the important job.
Oh, I have the...
I know,
midnight, and I haven't left the sink, and it's now nearly 8:10. But I've enjoyed every minute of it. I was just wondering how many times I've washed each cup and plate.
Got in.
Yes, yes.
Oh, sorry.
I wonder where you were going.
We're
going
to do another lap.
Oh, you've got to do next
year. How do you feel?
You've got to do next year.
Elated. I'm tender on the foot. Yeah. But other than that, okay.
How'd it go last night?
Okay. Warm during night, so you didn't have to bother for it, ladies. Pardon?
Is it better than the first night?
Both same. Yeah. Yeah, you didn't have to bother with leggings. That were a bonus. But I must have walked over 1.5 million stones.
What's your name?
Alfie Metcalf.
Where are you from?
Bradford, Yorkshire.
Are you with a box?
Well, congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
It's an achievement.
Yeah, thank you very much.
How are you feeling?
Tired but elated. Yeah. Yes.
Have you done this kind of thing before?
Yeah, I finished one before, so I think in some ways this was harder, yeah.
How was it overall for you? The route and the weather?
The weather was brilliant for me. I quite like it hot. The roots was obviously quite hard on the foot. I was done with the tip, but no, it was fine. Obviously, because I finished, I'm quite happy, so. Thank you.
Well done. You look too fit and energetic to have done 100 miles, but well done. Congratulations.
Aches and pains and sore bits, but it's really pleased. Yeah, all right, a few blisters and things, but not. They sort of seemed to settle down. They got to a point and didn't get any worse, so which was nice.
What were the toughest bits for you? Was it the hills?
There's rutted tracks later on, and during the night last night, it was so pitch black. It made it seem very long because it was parts of it is difficult to judge. Judge distance where it said to go in 600 yards. It's very difficult to work out to keep a tally of how far you've gone.
With some of these rotten tracks, you need to really look where you put your feet.
Yeah, that's right. So trying to get into a rhythm is quite difficult sometimes.
Is this something you've done hundreds before?
No, this is. So I tried Yordale last year and didn't make it, so I had to come back and I'm absolutely chuffed to bits to do it this time.
I'm really pleased.
Yeah, very. Yeah, Philip Saunders.
Saunders.
Nice, sit down.
Yeah, thank you.
The name comes in.
For you.
us there. Yeah. Done well. How was it for you last night? It's quite dark though.
It does that.
A few people said it was kind of extra dark. It must be tough because you've got to kind of look where you're walking as well.
Yeah, there was plenty of light going on.
I'll follow you in to get your thunderous applause.
Challenging, but and hot during the day. Together. Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
We meant to, and we did.
What are your names?
Elaine.
I can't speak. I'm afraid.
She's
my
Pam.
Voice has gone. I think the pollen from the rape has affected my throat, and I can't swallow, and I can't speak properly. Some say hallelujah to that. Me not being able to speak.
To be out of breath,
I'm not out of sex.
How are you feeling? How are you feeling? You must
overwhelmed.
Be tired. You must be tired.
No, I have been back to bed.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. It's a wonderful atmosphere, yeah.
You've been zipping around all over the place.
I have been zipping around, yes, yes.
How do you think it's gone over?
I think it's gone very well, actually. Yes. I've actually. Yeah. And everybody, this is the best bit of it, when everybody's coming in and welcoming in the last ones. Yeah. Have you enjoyed it?
Absolutely, yeah. Can't wait for the next one.
All right, okay. Thanks very much.
So, how are you feeling, sir?
Tired, very tired. My first 100.
Yeah.
I don't think it'll be the last.
Yeah, yeah. But, you've made it.
Yeah.
Great achievement.
100 mile for a T-shirt.
Yeah. How was it last night? Was it okay?
The last night was worse than the night before.
Yeah.
But it was okay.
Was it cold?
No, it wasn't cold at all. No. The weather was hot during the day, obviously, as you know. So we've enjoyed it.
My name is Kevin.
Yeah.
My call sign is M0PVO. And I'm currently fulfilling the role of controller at this event, which is the Wessex 100. It's a 100 mile walk. They've been at it now for the last 2 days. We've been at it for the last 2 days, come to that. Our role here in Rainer is to provide the communications. So we've had various checkpoints, total of the 16 checkpoints. We've had 13 operators dotted around these checkpoints with various bits of equipment, predominantly masts, to get the aerials nice and high, to provide a complete network of coverage throughout the whole of the area, which is from here in Alton, right the way deep into West Sussex, and that's been relayed via our headquarters at Fort Whidley. So it's been technically a complicated operation. We've been using three completely different sets of frequencies to get the radio traffic going backwards and forwards. Our operators, as I said, have been on site, and they've been assisting the marshals as appropriate. Some of our operators have got their own four-wheel drive, some of which are extremely specialised. And when I was at checkpoint four in the early hours of yesterday morning, I was actually conducting a lost person search, which I'm relieved to say was successful.
But you've also been ferrying people who've retired back home and all this kind of
thing. When it's been one person, I brought in a participant this morning in the early hours. I think it's about 2:30, 3 o'clock in the morning. He had to retire because he had really badly blistered feet. But what's been happening, as people have retired, there have been too many buses, again with our operators inside, and they've been ferrying around the various checkpoints. As people have dropped out, it's been communicated to us, we've told the organisers, and then we've arranged the pick-up.
Good. Well, congratulations on helping to run the event. It's obviously gone very well, and your service is invaluable, and hopefully we'll see you on the next one.
Looking forward to it. Catch up on some sleep now.
How's it going, Les?
Great. Yeah, great feedback here. Yeah. Fantastic feedback.
Seems to have gone smoothly overall.
Yeah, it has. It's been
great. We've just started to get a little bit of rain. Like,
yes, well, it's acclimatising us for Scotland next year. No, it's been really good.
How many have we got to come in now?
Only about 5 or 6. And they should be there with the next half an hour, they should be here.
And what about the retirement rate?
It's about 115, 116, which is about average. We expect about 20%.
Everybody is now back. Many thanks, especially for the kitchen staff who have been flogging themselves. All the checkpoints, I must admit, the food was pretty good. Of course. The food was fantastic. Not least yourselves. Brilliant. I've enjoyed meeting you all. And I'm sure, you know, you've had a fantastic time, haven't you? And I arranged for the shower so it'd be refreshing for the people at the end. Thank you, God. And thanks for all coming, and have a safe journey home.
Reflections of the fears I know I've left behind. I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending. I'm on my way. Can't stop me now. And you can. still so many answers I don't know. There are so many answers. Realize that to question is how we grow. To question is to grow. So I step out of the ordinary. I can feel my soul ascending. So what have you done today to make you feel proud?